Bill's time with this. First of all, I'd like to congratulate all of the inductees this evening. I know you love athletics as much as I do. I'd like to thank Josh Kessler and his committee for this award. Josh, you can't imagine the thrill and the honor that I felt when you called me to announce this award. At that time, I kind of choked up. That happens to me. I'm Italian, you know. But as Dave Ortiz would say, my eyes were really sweaty. In 1939, Lou Gehrig, as my son-in-law reminds me, once said, I consider myself the luckiest man on the face of the earth. Lou Gehrig had just found out that he had ALS, he was dying, and the Yankees had a great appreciation day for him. But he went on to say how blessed he was. And I guess I can say the same thing. I consider myself the luckiest person ever to attend St. Michael's College and to graduate as well. I say that because in 1949, when I graduated from Everett High School, having played football and baseball, there weren't many people running to my door to help me get to fulfill my dream to be a teacher and a coach. I was bouncing around like a lot of my friends were at that time in the 50s and 40s, bouncing around from job to job at the Boston Fish Pier and the shoe factories in Boston and et cetera, et cetera. When one day a stranger, never saw her before in my life, I was delivering soda to mom and pop stores. I was the assistant gopher, you might say. And a total stranger looked up at me. These were open trucks. And he looked up at me and he said, is your name John Barbati? I said, yes, it is. Why? He said, would you like to go to college? Well, I jumped off that truck. I think I may have tried to tackle him. And I said, where? And he said, St. Michael's College. I said, where's that? He said, Vermont. I said, where's that? But I was on my way. I can remember getting off the train here at Essex Junction. I think the train took about 10 hours from North Station at the time. But I was truly blessed. I came here and I met some remarkable teachers, remarkable. Father Larkin, Father Stankovich, Father D'Agostino, great, great teachers. Dr. Murphy, Dr. Fairbanks, those guys, they just encouraged us and they challenged us. And I'll tell you this, if we went in at 9 o'clock, we were in big trouble. Well, I was, as I said, blessed to have those teachers, and I certainly was blessed to have coaches who inspired us and were truly our role models. In fact, we idolized them. Guys like Doc Jacobs. What a man he was. Bill Piccioni, Barry Brannan, Arthur Coggio, just wonderful, wonderful teachers. You'd be proud to have them in your family, believe me. And I had certainly special teammates. We didn't have much, we didn't have buildings like this. We didn't have much, but we dug deep to help the school, to do the best we could, with a fighting spirit, which that song is true. Along the way, I married my high school sweetheart. Jean Penny and I met as juniors in high school, and we're going to have our 61st anniversary in June. And we talk about being blessed. I have 5 children, 7 grandchildren, and made a mistake, I had 2 great grandchildren. I'd like to now introduce my family, if I may. First of all, please, Jean, would you kindly stand for us? My daughter, Susan, and her husband, Dr. Herb Levine. My son, John Jr., and his wife, Cynthia. My daughter Nancy and her husband Scott Morrissey. My 4 grandchildren Owen Morrissey and Terry Morrissey. Again, thanks St. Michael's. Thanks my great teachers. Thanks coaches and teammates. I can close by saying, I can assure you that I will humbly cherish this award for the rest of my life. Thank you.